Ladies and gentlemen, today is the last episode we are doing where we have been discussing finances and purpose pursuit, how you can balance the two, finances and your purpose pursuit. Disclaimer is that I am not a financial guru. I'm not a personal financial guru, but being a life coach, I know a thing or two. And being a human being, a fellow human being also, we are in the same journey. I know a thing or two about these things. I might not have the millions of dollars in my bank account so that I can tell you what I'm going to tell you. That might not be the case, but it doesn't mean that I do not have the knowledge. Neither, it doesn't mean I do not have the passion for personal finances. I know personal finances is very critical for purpose pursuit. If you do not have money, the only thing you're thinking about is money. But if you're a person of purpose and you do have money, then you have enough opportunity and enough time to focus on your purpose. So let us close this series. It's been a wonderful series. Stay tuned.
Welcome to the Life Signatures Podcast with Lawrence Namale. Lawrence is a life coach, author, and keynote speaker who loves to tackle different topics on purpose, productivity, and resilience. His mission in life is to awaken all your boundless possibilities available in you. Life Signatures Podcast is dedicated to bring to reality every single person who knows that deep down in their gut, there's got to be more to life than this. And now, here is your host, Lawrence Namale.
Well, in closing this series, I will do a recap for you so that you can understand the things that I've been talking about. I talked about Mike Tyson. I talked about George Foreman in this series. I talked about how Mike Tyson was paid millions of dollars, and later on he declared himself bankrupt. Someone pulled a curtain and taught us some things about the expenses that Mike Tyson was making. He was buying suits, and every time he buys a suit, he buys a corresponding color of a Rolls Royce. If he buys a brown suit, he buys a brown Rolls Royce. If he buys a cream suit, he buys a cream Rolls Royce. We talked about George Foreman, who was also broke at some point in time. George Foreman is the man who is behind Rumble in the Jungle with, guess who? Muhammad Ali. I think I get my facts correct. George Foreman. They went to Zaire and they fought. And it's still billed as one of the legendary boxing events in the universe since man was born, of course, at least recorded and televised. And George Foreman, right now, he went back into the ring. Okay, not right now, he went back to the ring, but at some point in time, he went back to the ring at 40 years of age, reclaimed his heavyweight title and started putting finances in order. And now he's having franchises of his meat, selling meat and so on and so forth. Even nutritionists are recommending his grills. He's selling grills, man. So we need to look at those guys as examples that at some point in time, it's not about how much money is coming. It's about what kind of discipline we're having, what kind of character we are having. There's discipline and then there is character. Discipline means that you force, you intend, you do. Character means you've done it so much so that it is part and parcel of you. You don't even have to think about it. Now, we also talked about finances having two major aspects in the way you interact with your finances. Number one, you are going to interact with the finances as an event, or You're going to interact with the finances as a process. Those people who think they can get finances as an event, they do what? They go and they play lottery. Or they go to church and they sow a seed, and putting that in quotes, expecting to get a miracle. There's nowhere in the scriptures that tell you that when you give a seed, you're going to get a miracle, and that is a sustainable way in which you should be getting your finances. It's not there. It's not there. All right. And if it's there, it is not supposed to be the mainstay of you and your income. So people interact with the finances as an event in terms of income, and those people don't go so far. If all you're waiting for is an event so that you can get some money, you will not have enough money to help you to pursue your purpose. And also, people use events in terms of expenses, in terms of spending the money, the outgo of the money is in an event. It's very easy for us to spend. I've said a gazillion times, spending doesn't need to be taught. It is inherent. Every kid knows how to spend. You don't need to teach them. And they don't even have to account for it. They just know, if I have money, I can get candy. If I have money, I can get a suit. If I have money, I can get a hoverboard. If I have money, I can get an iPod, an iPad. If I have money, I can get this. They know how to spend. What we don't know is process in which we can invest our money or save our money or create value so that income can come. Anyway, so we talked about the pillars, the big pillars that you should look at in your finances. The first pillar is the pillar of income. I love that pillar so much. I do think that someone has got to create a book out of it. Just income, just focusing on income for a person of purpose. Income follows value. It doesn't follow graduation. It doesn't follow curriculum. It doesn't follow a degree or a diploma. It doesn't follow all those things that we put ourselves through. Income follows value. If you can figure out how to create value, you figured out income. And if you can figure out how to create value in one place, if you look carefully, they are sisters and brothers and cousins of that particular module of income, which means you can have more than one stream of income. So that's the first thing that we talked about. Your income. Nobody ever became a millionaire or a billionaire without income. Nobody ever got financially free without income. Nobody got income. And I'm talking, when you talk about income, we're not talking about some money your uncle gives you for pocket money once a term. Income is something that is sustainable. It's like a river. It's a flowing river. Have you ever seen a river drying up? Seldom. When a river dries up, it's news. But a river will always be flowing. That is what income is. Always flowing. And if you are going to have something that is always flowing, you've got to create value for it so that it can always be paid for. So income. The second pillar is about your expenses and how you can curtail those expenses so that you are not spending on wants, you're spending on needs. And you're holding yourself with so much high discipline. And we've said that the worst of expenses are those ones that go so that people can change their brand and they change their identity. You buy a Nike shoe and then you walk around feeling like your identity has changed. You buy a Nike t-shirt, you buy a car, you buy some curtains, you buy an iPhone and you walk around like you've arrived. That is the worst kind of expenditure. This kind of expenditure should only come when you're financially free. And, you know, and even though, by the way, we should never ever spend a single cent so that we can change our identity. Let's work on our identities. Let us not spend on so that our identities can be created. Let us work on our identities, but let us not spend on them. Thirdly, we talked about saving. This is the most bare thing you can do with your money, is putting aside some money, a percentage of your money. Every time the income comes, doesn't matter whether it's daily or monthly or weekly, put aside a percentage. They normally say 10%. Put aside that 10%. Why are you doing that? So that number four, you can invest. In fact, you can do this consecutively. You can save and invest all at the same time, which is very highly recommended. And number four, it is about investing. Invest your finances in such a way that you're going to get more. At any one point in time, everyone should be an investor. Investment is not about how rich you are. It's about how disciplined you are, even with a cent. Can you invest? Can you find an avenue where you can be able to invest that particular cent? So do the investments and let them help you. Then yesterday we talked about number five, doing a reserve account. Creating a reserve account so that your burn rate is catered for in case the taps of income dry up. When the taps of income, and I say, don't you ever be fooled by income. It has a, and I know I talked about income as a river which never dries up. But in terms of personal finances, sometimes this income normally dries up, or it starts trickling down, or it starts becoming less and less. And yet the expenses are more and more. So even as you're curtailing your expenses, you are also saving aside, putting aside some money so that you can cater for your reserve account. In case the income is not there, you dig into your reserve account, and guess what you do? You have enough time to think of creating another form of income, and therefore you are consistently pursuing your pursuit. But if that is not the case, guess what? You don't have time for purpose. Why? Because all you're doing is survive. All you're doing is trying to survive, trying to make a buck, and trying all the while trying to pay the bills. You don't have time for your purpose. So that's where the reserve account comes in. But today I want us to close with a topic that I am not so conversant with. My friend Tony Mugisha, which I'm going to host him at one point in time in this episode. I'm going to call him up and going to have this discussion. He talks about insurance. There are different types of insurance. And I know many people say, I don't want to pay insurance because at the end of the day, I'm not going to get an accident. At the end of the day, this is not going to... There are different types of insurance. There is life insurance, there's education insurance, and so on and so forth. But insurance is some of the thing. It's one of the major things we should be looking at. Saving for retirement is some kind of insurance. Saving for education and college is some kind of insurance. Saving for life itself is some kind of insurance. Saving for medical emergencies is some kind of insurance. What is the importance of insurance? Again, it works like this reserve account I've talked about. You're insuring. The only thing with insurance is that it's organized towards a particular thing that you can claim. For example, when you insure your car over against an accident, even if you're paying premiums and so on and so forth, what happens is that the moment there is an accident, guess what happens? The insurance money comes in and pays it. And this is paining me because I did not have car insurance and my car engine knocked. This is the second day I'm podcasting today. It's in February. The car engine knocked and I'm being asked for some serious dollars. Insurance would have covered that. So I'm saying this to tell you that now my life is thrown in disarray financially because the organization that I had for this year, there was no plan for, you know, paying X amount of dollars towards a car repair. It wasn't there. But now it is there because I did not insure the thing. Insured. My friend was telling me, why don't you even insure your podcasting equipment? You spend top dollar getting your podcasting equipment. Why don't you insure it? Insurance is normally going to go targeting on something. And let me talk to some super spiritual people here for a minute. Some of you feel like if you took insurance for medical cover, for example, you are opening, quote unquote, you're opening the door for the devil to come and make you sick. So that money that you've said, oh, if I'm going to take insurance, then I'm going to fall sick. I've opened the door for me falling sick. No, you haven't opened the door. You're just becoming wise. Remember the parable of the talents? What did Jesus say? He said that one was given two, one was given five, one was given three. The one was given two, they dug and they hid it. That's the mentality. If you're not taking insurance, that's the mentality. You're hiding that talent. And when the master comes back, he says, you're a wicked servant. You should have put it somewhere, at least should, to earn some interest. So insurance cover helps you to have peace of mind. It helps you to overcome some eventualities that blindside you in life when you're busy trying to pursue your purpose. So you can insure against very many things, but I would advise this. Life is important. Education and college funds for your kids is important. And medical, it is also important. Well, ladies and gentlemen, I am not a financial guru, but I'm a purpose coach, and I know for sure that it is very important. It's absolutely critical for anyone who is pursuing their purpose. It is critical for them to talk about their finances. Because if your finances are in a mess, guess what? Your purpose will also be in a mess. Tomorrow, we will start talking about another series, and I'm looking forward to this one. You don't want to miss this. We're going to talk about the pillars of an effective life. It's going to be an interesting series. I can't wait for this. But until then, you guys, get your finances in order. God bless you. Bye-bye. I love you.
Thank you for listening to Life Signatures Radio. If you enjoyed today's show, subscribe to Life Signatures Radio on iTunes, Stitcher, or visit our website at lifesignatures.libsyn.com. Life Signatures Radio, fresh, clean, and inspiring.